After bringing down aliens in The Avengers, playing a corrupt politician in American Hustle, Jeremy Renner is now exposing the shady tactics of the CIA in his new film, Kill the Messenger. Hi, I'm Terry Hitchcock. In Harkins Theater's Behind the Screens, I sat down with Jeremy to talk about his role as Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist Gary Webb.
Gary Webb, San Jose Mercury News.
You believe in conspiracy theories, Gary?
No, I don't believe in conspiracy theories. Conspiracies, yes. I believe it. There's nothing theory about it.
So I watched this movie, and the first thing I want to do is get online, and I wanted to see if his speech was somewhere and all that. When you read the story, what was the first thing you wanted to go back and research and look into?
I looked up the apology letter, the retraction from San Jose Mercury News. Couldn't find it. And I went to, I just started researching a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
And I had people help me research things, and so. And so I'm glad that, you know, when circles latch like that, when people are like, oh yeah, that's, I want to do that.
One of the DEA's most wanted, not only not in jail for eternity, but apparently on the government payroll, admitting in open court that he brought in thousands of kilos of cocaine to the U.S. every day, for them.
For who?
The U.S. government, or with them, or at least while they were looking the other way.
Jesus.
This is the biggest story the Merc's ever had.
One of the things that I did stumble upon was a fairly well-documented statement, I think, from his former editor saying he was a man of passion but not of fairness. Mm. After doing all this, do you agree with that or completely disagree?
Man of passion, not fairness. Well, I guess I could agree with that. Getting into some sensitive, I guess I agree with that. I mean, greatness as a journalist is his courageousness and his braveness. In this story particularly, where he wrote what's right. I mean, he basically had it right.
But,
you know, he went up against a lot of very big, powerful people that just attacked him and that didn't take the story further, tragically.
Yeah.
But Gary asked for it also, you know. He spoke a little hyperbole and writes a little oversimplified, you know, so that can, you know. But yeah, he's a out of the box kind of guy.
Which you tend, I would imagine, to play in life.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But, you know, that's what I respect about him, and that's why I think he's ultimately an amazing human being.
This story scares people.
I'm your big brother.
Well, it should.
Be careful.
I liked the way you played this character, and it's probably the way she is in real life. Sue puts up with a lot.
Yeah.
She forgives some things other women might not have forgiven. But yet she's not weak. In any way did I go, gosh, she's kind of weak. She's putting up with a lot. You played her, I thought, really strongly, really well.
It was almost tricky because when I met Sue in real life, there's like a quiet strength to her. It's just that's what it was. And to talk to her now, all these years after Gary passed away, and she still loves him so much, you know, she fiercely loves her children. She still has so much respect for him as a journalist. You know what I mean? Like, it was all, it kind of told me everything I needed to know.
Did she know who you were? Was she a fan of yours? Or when you first met, it was...
No, she was like, what is this broad doing playing me?
Where's Sandra Bullock?
No, it was really great to get to meet her. I mean, you do feel like, you know, we shot a lot that's not in the movie, too, because you tend to do that in movies. You shoot a lot. And in a weird way, the story ended up focusing a lot on the story and the CIA and the this and the that. And that is what happened to their family a little bit. Like, it did feel like this was the thing that swallowed them up.
Yeah.
You know, so in a weird way, it's not odd that it happened in the movie, too. And, of course, I want her to feel very represented and hopefully she will.
There is a heartbreaking scene between him and his son where his son looks at him and says, I'm disappointed in you. And what parent does not dread that moment? Oof. You're a relatively new dad, and I know you probably haven't screwed up yet where she can sense it, but...
Yeah, but just
does it
even,
weigh on
this
you?
Even if my little brother or sister said that to me, you know, that would be a hard knock.
Am I being followed?
What's your angle, Webb? Some governmental informants are scumbags.
Look, I was under the impression that you guys had something to say to me. But to answer your question, no. My angle is that the American government knew drugs were put on the streets to fund an illegal war.
Yeah. They say this guy made the CIA look bad. Have you ever inadvertently made something look bad? or someone look bad by accident.
Oh, in this case, sure, it's intentional. I'm sure a lot of, I'm sure I've made someone look bad all the time, somehow, but not because I wanted to.
Right.
And when it, if I did want to make somebody look bad, it would be done in a very funny way.
Yeah. And hopefully they'll take it as such.
Yes, exactly.
Because it can go bad.
Yeah.
American kids, we're going to die in that war.
American kids did die, and they're still dying. Just not the ones you care about, apparently.
We'd never threaten your children, Mr. Webb.
Might? What'd you say?
You say you always learn something from the people you play. What did you learn from him?
What's it like to be on the other side, man? What's the, about journalists, but journalism, investigative reporting, being in a with editors and having that relationship between an editor and a journalist? That's interesting to me.
Do you read news differently now? Do you watch news differently?
Yeah, sure, sure. I mean, all of that. I mean, I was aware of some things, but like to really kind of like get my teeth in it, and yeah, I thought it was a really, really interesting world. It's actually a lot more creative and not quite as corporate as I thought.
I'm not finished with it! I'm not finished!
This is a true story. Some stories are just too true to tell. Where you be for the
revolution. He was so passionate about getting this film done. You've got to check out Kill the Messenger. If you want to see more of your Hollywood favorites, log on to HarkinsTheaters.com and check out Harkins Behind the Screens.